The movie starts with Holly Golightly, also known as Lula Mae Barnes, wearing a stunning Givenchy gown. She gets out of a taxi in front of Tiffany and company as the sun is rising. It seems like she's coming home after a night out, while everyone else is just starting their day. She has a white paper bag and takes out a pastry and coffee, enjoying her breakfast outside Tiffany's, looking into the windows. The Sing Prisoner is played in the background by Alan Reed, who is also the voice of Fred Flintstone. It's truly a wonderful movie with Audrey Hepburn, and the music is just not the same as it is today. Compared to this, Henry Mancini's music is exceptional. It's quite sad that there aren't many young people allowed to continue creating such wonderful music. Truman Capote wanted Marilyn Monroe to play the role. Marilyn didn't take part in it. The movie puts its spin on the book but still captures the essence and charm. Holly Golightly is not some poor girl loping along trying to fall in love and marry the rich. She's looking for a wealthy gentleman she can pin her. Holly is in many ways self-deluded and has stars in her eyes. There's something wonderful about her. She believes everything is going to magically work out, and she hides from herself that she's living high off the hog as the mistress of one rich man or another. On the one hand, she's the toast of New York society, but at the same time, she's an almost naive young lady from the sticks who has dreamed her way into a Manhattan paradise, but one that could crumble at any moment. She also survives by her sexuality. The film casts the male lead in a similar role, a gigolo, perhaps to restore a sense of balance. And yet Holly, at least in the movie, is redeemed by her ability to love. She loves me greatly. She loves her brother Fred, whom she left when Holly reads a letter from her brother Fred, and we see the vulnerability and longing in her eyes. These moments add layers of emotion to the film and make it even more memorable. She loves her cat. She ultimately loves her neighbor Paul, romantically as it turns out, although again in the book he is gay. Another popular scene from Breakfast at Tiffany's is when Holly Golightly sings Moon River on her windowsill. It's such a heartfelt and intimate moment that showcases Audrey Hepburn's beautiful voice. The song itself has become synonymous with the film and is often considered one of its most memorable aspects. As for the dialogue, there are so many great lines in the movie, but one that stands out is when Holly says, "The only way to stay sane is to go a little crazy sometimes." It's a reminder to embrace our quirks and live life to the fullest. The story is about how fragile and easily broken life is in the big city, New York. But Hollywood turned it into a very satisfying Hollywood ending, which pleased audiences. I wouldn't say it is a masterpiece, but it is a fine example of good Hollywood romance, and Audrey Hepburn steals the show. You can't help but feel moved by her, even if parts of the movie appear off to you. She navigates her way through relationships and encounters with various intriguing characters. The film explores themes of love, identity, and the pursuit of happiness. It's a captivating and sometimes bittersweet tale that keeps you engaged from start to finish. There is a heart-wrenching moment that tugs at the viewer's heartstrings and leaves them rooting for their love to prevail. When Paul, played by George Peppard, confesses his love, Paul looks into Holly's eyes, his voice filled with emotion, and says, "Holly, I can't bear the thought of you leaving. I want to be with you, to share my life with you. Please, don't go." His words are filled with sincerity and a plea for her to stay. It's a powerful moment that showcases the depth of their connection. Holly's character in the movie is quite relatable for many viewers today because she's not easy to figure out. It's like she represents the complexity and struggles that people go through in their own lives. We all have our layers and uncertainties, so seeing that in Holly's character can resonate with viewers, and Audrey Hepburn being cast as Holly adds to her iconic status. She brought such grace and charm to the role, which has made her a timeless icon. It's no wonder people are still drawn to her persona even today. The movie's ending doesn't provide clear answers to all the questions you might have, which can be disappointing if you were expecting a traditional romance story. Audrey Hepburn's character might seem distant at times, which can be surprising. However, it's important to remember that she is an enchanting actress and a dedicated humanitarian, and her performance is worth appreciating. Holly's dressing sense in the movie is fabulous. Audrey Hepburn's character had such a unique and iconic style. From her little black dresses to those chic accessories, she knew how to rock a fashionable look. It's no wonder that her fashion choices in the movie continue to inspire people even today. Audrey Hepburn's elegance and timeless fashion sense left a lasting impression. Many aspects to this film are not perfect. For one, the acting is not the greatest. The film's major flaw is in its disrespectful portrayal of Mr. Raffray's Yunyoshi. the sole Asian presence in the film, white man Mickey Rooney was cast as the character, and he completely outshone Asian stereotype. Despite being ignored, his depiction of this character is offensive and not even humorous. The characters were cringeworthy, but what made them so offensive was the buck teeth, an overly accent, and annoying stereotypical stereotypes.